Mr. Mestassi is a state certified statistician, economist, and holds a master's degree in economic sciences. He is also the co-chair of MENA-OECD investment program. Please join me to extend a very warm welcome to Mr. Mestassi.
When Dr. Dunfried invited me to make a lecture, I told him that I can do it only in French or in Arabic. Given the high level of the participants. So I elaborate my lecture in French. I sent it to him for translation. But when I saw yesterday and today too, your open mind and your sportive mind, on peut dire ça, your sportive mind, I decided to make my speech in English. So I beg your pardon for my bad English and for the faults I could make. First of all, I would like to thank very much ICD, the board of ICD, Dr. Dunfried, and the staff and all the staff. The theme of this conference is complex and current in a lot of its sides. The topic I've chosen in this frame is very important in general, but especially in the case of the MENA region and Morocco, my country. In fact, when I started thinking about the relationship between culture and development, this is the topic of my lecture, I found that the references are so various and rich. However, I think this topic still very interesting for research. In my paper lecture distributed, I think, you can find some indication for that. To begin my intervention, it is necessary to give definitions both for culture and development. For UNESCO, the culture is the complex of distinctive spiritual, material, intellectual, and emotional features that characterize a society or social group. It includes not only the arts and letters, but also modes of life, the fundamental rights of the human being, value system, traditions, and beliefs. Other definitions, like the definition given by Paul Schaeffer, includes in the culture, even the political and economic systems, technology, and science. In the other side, the development will be intended in this lecture as a general progress, both in economic and human area. Given this definition, I will discuss briefly their implication in general, and in a second part, discuss the relationship between culture and development in the MENA region. In general, the notion of the culture is composite. We can say that is composite, and includes measurable and non-measurable elements. Second, the relationship between culture and development is extremely complex. Yet the cultural production don't obey to the economic logic. Consequently, the value of this production is quite difficult to evaluate. The statistics show that the participation of the culture in the GDP, when this statistics exists, is limited at 6% maximum. This figure don't represent, I am sure, that real volume of cultural that don't represent the real volume of the cultural activity. Third remark, the difficulty to evaluate the real weight of the culture in the economy is a great handicap to define a politic or a strategy for its development. In the conclusion of this part, I think that this difficulty results of the fact that in our analysis, we use a material tools to study an immaterial phenomena. We often forgot that the externalities in the case of culture is more important than the simple fact to buy or sell a book or to pay a ticket to watch a movie or a play. The relationship between culture development in the MENA region. I will discuss this issue in the context of the called Arab Spring. I think that what is happening now in our countries is launching of long processes of fundamental transformation in the matter of culture intended largely and consequently in the field of development. The religion seems going to play a reinforced political role in the region. What we are constating, observing now in our region, we are observing the emergence of a new cultural value. These values are inspired by the universal values. They are principally three. The democracy as a participative mode of political governance. With the Arab Spring, this value is rehabilitated by focusing on the role of women and the role of youth as a vector of modernity and a great potential for the development. On the other side, democracy must go together with economic liberalism, noble definition, and with cultural freedom. Second value emerging, social justice associated with human dignity, linked with the first value. This value implies fundamentally the connection between the political and economic power. In a dictatorial system, the connection of these powers conducts to the social injustice and fair, and parallelly to a cultural system serving the dictator. This value was one of the most slogan claimed by population while in the Spring Arab. The third value is the good governance. It concerns three principles, two values. The fight against corruption. In the country of the region MENA, the corruption is fundamentally a cultural and traditional problem. Its origins are historical. Public and even private services used to be paid like corruption. Second, value. The accountability. Every abuse made by civil servant or even elected person must be punished by the law. Third value is the evaluation of the public policies, in particular, the evaluation of the governmental program. The Prime Minister in the new Moroccan constitution have to present once a month to the parliament the achievement of his government. This presentation is discussed publicly and transmitted by television. one or a kind of value. We discussed a lot about the religion this afternoon, but the religion value is profoundly embedded in the cultural, social, and political system in the MENA region. The religion constitutes first a means to access to the spirituality. It is also a cultural reference and an identity. It is finally used to justify and claim a position on the political field. The Arab societies, and Muslim too, are today largely influenced by internal and external factors, especially by global integrism and globalization. Indeed, the free circulation of the religion cultural products, books, CD, website, facilitate the growing of these influences in our societies, which are suffering simultaneously of high level of poverty, exclusion, and of a lack of strong regulation of the religious field. In Morocco, the interpretation of the religion and the regulation of the religion field is the exclusive competence of the king in coordination with a council of religious specialists. How to promote?
Please, you still have 5 minutes, please.
Sorry?
5 minutes. Five minutes.
You have five minutes left.
5 minutes. Five minutes. How to promote this new cultural value for development? There is two kind of conditions for the promotion of these new values: internal conditions and external conditions. Concerning internal conditions, we can speak about a high and sustainable level of growth associated with an equitable repartition of the revenue. We can demonstrate that the relationship between culture and development is not univoc. Second, profound institutional and legal reform in the field of the media, public liberties, and harmonization of the national legislations with the international convention in the matter of human rights, women's conditions, intellectual property, the demonopolization and the regulation of the audiovisual sector. Other point, the promotion of the youth role in the society by specific strategy. Indeed, the young population demonstrated that she can constitute a strong vector to enhance cultural value looking for the future. Also, enhance the role of the NGOs, given their capacity to cover a large territory and to mobilize a large part of the population on practical projects for the local development. Concerning the external conditions, I think that the multiplication of positive international initiatives with a minimum of conditionalities is necessary. The countries of our region need a help by innovative projects. One new roadmap for bilateral and multilateral cooperation is necessary. This new form of cooperation must focus in the other side on helping to eradicate extremism and immune our societies against the negative effects of the bad cultures. In particular, the international and regional financial institutions must give the priority while financing projects to the field connected with culture to maximize their externalities. In conclusion, despite the large number of studies done about culture and development, institutions concerned like universities or NGOs have now and interesting opportunities to study more scientifically and methodologically the impact of the culture on the development or vice versa. The structure of ICD and its capacity to mobilize high level of competence can, I am sure, contribute with efficiency to this project. I thank you very much for your listening.